Welcome back to educator.com. Today we're going to talk about, in this lesson, specifically about this interpersonal speaking part. If you remember, before we've gone through a very general explanation of what is the speaking skills testing like. We saw the scoring, we saw the different structures that we will find, we saw the structure that it will find there, so we'll have different kind of testing of the speaking skills. That would be the interpersonal speaking, and the other situation would be the presentational. In this lesson, we're gonna go over the interpersonal speaking. What do we have to prove here is how well can we communicate in a conversation. So what does it mean? It's going to be a simulated conversation with, yeah, it's going to be recorded, but another person that is going to giving us lines. You need to prove how spontaneous you are in this conversation, and it means that you have not only to give the information required, but also you have to get influenced, get affected by what it's going on, so you can expand the ideas and you can add some other information with other details. We'll go over it a little bit later. What do we have? The instructions are going to come in a box. As I told you before, we will have 1 minute. I recommend you to have just 1 minute to go over it, or even not even going over them, and 1 minute to read the theme and the introduction. It's going to be pretty simple. The box is going to come on top of it, and then in the introduction, it would tell you a situation, it would describe you what is happening. For example, you are just applying for a job, and the person from the job sends you an email that is asking you about certain capacities or skills that you should have for the position. Now, go over the conversation with the person, giving the information that the person is requiring you to give. That is the introduction with those different things that is describing the situation that is coming, and then the script. So I recommend you to go over the script and the introduction specifically, so you are more familiar with the situation and with the develop of the conversation. It needs to be natural. It needs to be adequate for the situation. Therefore, the vocabulary has to be as well adequate. You need to give vocabulary and grammar that is proper for the moment, and also for the different information that you are going over. The contents, the moment, context, the moment, the stimulus. The reason why I say this is because if you want to be natural in a conversation, you need to pay attention to these factors. If you pay attention to them, it's going to be much better for you to say what you are thinking. And for example, if you see that it's a situation of employment, therefore you know the context is going to be between, it's of course going to be formal, and you have to be giving answers where you have to prove yourself as a person with the skills that are required for the position. So that is going to be a context, like asking about your skills, giving information about your skills, and of course trying to elevate yourself as much as possible. You need to know the vocabulary that is appropriate, for example, for the greetings and for the closings for a situation like this one, and also the vocabulary that is appropriate for elevating your skills, like which words can you use to describe yourself as a good person for the position, as a good candidate. And the stimulus, you would have different lines coming from the person that are gonna not only ask you about information that you should answer, and not just because of the conversation, but also as a reminder, so you know, because that's a very important rubric for the scoring of the exam. If you don't address the points that you're required, then you're not addressing a point that should be scored. So yeah, sorry for that, but it's important to remember that. But those stimulus are also fine and great, because you have the chance to give more answers, to be dynamic in the conversation.